What if I went live at the correct time, 8 o'clock? That clock is wrong right now. That clock will be right in the spring, though, when we spring ahead. So I don't even have to touch it. It'll automatically adjust in the spring. And nobody's watching anyway right now, so it doesn't matter. I think people are used to me starting later anyway. It was always supposed to be in at 8 o'clock and kind of got. Hey, Cowboy Swami's there. Thanks for tuning in. Got a few people coming in. Eric is there. Morning. Holy cow. Kind of late here. There's Mike. Yeah, I'm tuning in. Pete's there. Matt. Enrique. Todd. Cowboy Swami, I like your new videos. I can't. I'm opening up. Matt is asking, did I sell the North Flag? I did. I bought it on a whim and I sold it on a whim. Hey guys, hey Rob. Chris is wearing his Oris Big Crown today. Ken's checking in from Pittsburgh. So my buddy out in Salt Lake City, Jiro, sent over this bronze coin. It's sealed up, so pretty cool. I'll have to check it out. I don't know much about it, but pretty cool. Thanks. Set that right there. Tennessee Mike is chiming in. So I have one of my moderators. Ken's wearing the Laco Type B dial. Nice. Hey, my buddy Brad is here. Yeah, I actually don't have a pilot style watch. Interesting. Maybe one day I will. You know what? I'll probably put that on my list. I need to do that soon. I was originally going after that Stova, the white dial one, but I'm kind of glad I didn't buy it. So because there's some newer ones out where they have like a kind of a patina look to the dial, and then they have the thermally blued hands with the patina in the loom for the hands. That one really has my attention. I think I want that one with the manual wind only, not automatic. I am wearing the new Oris Aquis with the new movement. Cowboy Swami is asking, do you like the Boulder Expedition worth the money? I think so, as long as you can get them pretty cheap. I know when they first came out, they were pretty affordable. I don't know if they still offer discounts or, you know, if you can get them on the used market or something like that. I don't remember what the full price is on those. But, yeah, I mean, I'm assuming I'm thinking about the right one, but the titanium automatic. So I think that's actually a really good watch for the price and the size. Oh, James said he picked up the Stova Pilot Flieger, not his favorite. Yeah. Anish says, hey, Rob, new colorways of the Casio Oak. What are your thoughts? Well, I bought the two new colorways, and hopefully I'll have those soon. They didn't show up today, so I think that's going to show up soon. Let's see. Mike says he picked up one of those Heimdallr Monsters. Yeah, somebody else in my Patreon group picked one up. I think a couple of people actually picked them up. One of them picked up like a red dial one. It looks almost like a one-to-one rep of the Monster. Obviously the dial's different and everything like that. Everything looks a little different, but the case and bracelet and everything looks like it's almost one-to-one. So I don't know, it looks pretty dang good. At some point I'll get one in and check it out, but they're not my favorite. You know, it's not my favorite thing to do when you have like a one-to-one rep. You know, when you do like a strong homage or something like that, I'm fine with that. But guys, I'm really digging this Oris very much. And I think there's only two colorways of the new movement one, but I do like the display case back and the movement. So far, so good. Everything seems to be working really good. I'm not sure what it's doing time-wise, though. I haven't been really tracking it. Hey, Slicey Dicey's here. You know what? I think this might be running a little slow, but maybe I didn't set it right, or maybe I didn't have enough wind on it. But I'll throw this on the time grapher and I'll track it a little bit more. I'll adjust the time and everything. But see, Hector's checking in from Brazil, wearing a citizen, I can't say it, BB4026, waiting on his oars. Oh yeah, the taxi cab watch. So my buddy Craig, who lives south of me, this was a limited edition watch he picked up, I think from Toppers, if I'm not mistaken. Seawolf chronometer grade, kind of, yeah, it does have like a taxi checker pattern to it. Has a kind of one of the, in my opinion, one of the best Jubilee bracelets out there. The nice strong taper to it, and then check this spring-loaded butterfly clasp, makes it much easier, more comfortable to wear. So I did an unboxing video on this. I will post that up soon, and then of course I'll do a full video. But yeah, the bracelet, and then it's not sized for me, so it's a little loose. But they did a really good job. And you got to keep in mind too, because it's a butterfly clasp, the spring part where you would think it would pinch you is actually covered by the butterfly clasp part. So there's no pinching or anything. It's like phenomenal on wrist. So, and it's just one of those things. Craig's not a serial flipper necessarily. Like, he typically keeps his watches. He thinks quite a bit before he even buys them, even if it's a Skimmy or whatever those are. And I know he picked that up, you know, based on the fact that he wanted it, and he's trying to push towards picking up the Speedmaster, I think he wants. So that's part of flipping a few watches to be able to, hey, there's Craig, we're just talking about you, to be able to afford a higher watch or a different watch that you want. You know, you got to flip a couple of watches that might be awesome watches, maybe watches you really don't want to sell, but you sometimes just have to sacrifice those to move to another watch. Yeah, the Zodiac is sweet. I might look into those again. Personally, I don't really care for the bezel, but maybe it'll grow on me. I think I like something a little less bold. I know that's crazy to say with some of the watches I have, but it's a bit much. But it is a great case, perfect size, excellent bracelet, and probably one of the best butterfly clasp out there. Slicey dicey. Everywhere I go, someone is talking about a Seamaster. Yeah, Seamaster's right here, man. Let's see. Floridian is saying, Rob, sounds like you will start pulling on call again soon. Probably not. There's some other things I've done. So I think Floridian's talking about something I'm doing, because you guys know I have like a Patreon. Most people maybe don't know, because I haven't really advertised it. But let's see. Yeah, the butterfly class does have some expansion. Well, Slicey Dicey, you don't have to have a, I mean, maybe it's best to not get one because everybody else has one. Like, there's that too that really gets to me. I prefer to have watches that other people don't have. And sometimes when you share some really cool watches that you have, that it kind of makes them popular. You probably experience that with knives, because Slicey Dicey has a knife channel. So, but he will show like really cool knives, and then all of a sudden everybody goes and buys those knives. So now it makes it, as a community thing, it like kind of makes it a little less special. It just does. So that's where I really gravitate towards, even if it's a watch that everybody wants. Like, say if everybody was after a Zodiac Seawolf, well, they make some super, super limited edition ones like this one. Those would be the ones to get. So now, yes, you still have the same watch as everybody else, but you have it in a limited edition release. So there are some harder to get Seamasters, and really you don't see a ton, even in the watch community, you don't see a ton of these white dial Seamasters. Most everybody has the black, the chrome, you know, the grayish one with the blued, and no, Floridian. No, so here's the deal. This time of year, and I just covered it, it's fine. I just covered it up because nobody wants to see it, but I'm not going to wear gloves, right? All that was a hangnail. And this time of year, with like a little bit of dry skin and stuff like that, don't pick at hangnails. That's all I can say. So it's healing up fine, and it's no big deal. My number one troll hunter is here, Dane Celine Driver channel. So always nice to have him on board. BM is asking, with Zodiac, what's your thoughts on the STP movements? I don't have a problem with them, and actually, this one's a chronometer grade, so it's like the highest end one. I think they're fine. Rio's checking in from Riverside, California. He's asking, are you getting a new Benros timepiece in to review? No. That was one I wrote down, right? I was supposed to get a hold of them. I'll write it down again. Ben Ross. All right, I wrote it down because I didn't check with them. Or maybe I did, I can't remember, but I'll check with them again. Let's see. Mr. Arson says there is a video saying the new Oris does not actually have 5-day power reserve. More seriously, the minute hand will jump when adjusting time. Do you have the same issues? Yes and yes. So those videos are correct. I think there is 100 or 5-day power reserve on it if you get a full wind. To get a full wind, I think you have to turn this thing like 210 turns. So you got to remember there's two barrels in there and they have gear reduction. So you have to really, really, really turn these. And even when somebody thinks they're active and they're doing enough to, spin that rotor and charge up two barrels, let alone one barrel. Most people that wear automatic watches that have more than one, two, three, four, five of them, they never get a full charge on those watches. Unless you have like a power meter and you can actually monitor it, like that North Flag I had, and there's a bunch of others out there too, but they're not getting a full charge. So for them to say, I'm not getting my 120-hour power reserve, did you get a full wind? You have to confirm you got a full wind. And then as far as the minute hand jumping, yes, it does. And I think that wannabe engineer, it was the channel, he did the video on it. This one does the exact same thing. However, it also is corrected by doing the exact same thing that he shared. And that's where you wiggle the crown. And I don't mean like wiggle it like this, but you like turn it back and forth. And I'll show this all on video. I'm just not going to do it right now. But you just kind of turn the crown a little bit. Just enough. You're not going to move the minute hand, but you just turn it a little bit and then you push it in. Most times it's not going to jump on you. Now, when you pop it out, you can also do it, but you're popping it out to adjust the time. So, and that's where you get the big jump, not necessarily when you put it in. So why say it's 120-hour power reserve if you can never actually? No, you can. The watch can. Let me rephrase that. The watch can get 120-hour power reserve. You just wearing it on your wrist and doing things that you think is active, you're probably not going to get a full charge. But that's nothing against the movement. You're not getting a full charge on your Seiko Monster or whatever. You know what I'm saying? So the only way to know this for sure is to like throw it on a time grapher. You can check the amplitude. You can do the from a dead stop. You can do and count the turns. But I think Oris said 200, if I'm not mistaken, I think it was 210 rotations to get a full wind on both barrels. So I have the model spinning behind me here, and I did not do a full wind on that. Maybe I will. I'm kind of waiting for it to die, but you can see it's still alive. Still beating. And I didn't wind this all the way. So I will probably let this one die, and then I'll probably do a full wind on that and see. You'll have to look up the amplitude on the time, what an amplitude means, beat error, all that. That's actually good stuff to just do a quick read up on. I don't know that I'm necessarily qualified to try to explain it. I could probably do a video and explain it, but I'm sure there's already videos out there explaining it. Yes, James, and again, I probably need to do a video on that, right? So James is saying he likes on the ETA 2892, which is a phenomenal movement. It's like a kind of like a more refined 2824 kind of, but it's thinner and all that stuff. It basically clicks when the clutch engages when the mainspring is fully wound. So you can kind of tell when you're fully wound. Floridian, I am drinking a Czech Pilsner. Jay, I have seen pictures of that monster. I have not actually handled one. So anyway, back to the movements. I would like to actually make a video on and talk about, all these newer in-house, right? So like the Aorus, the Seamaster, some Tudor in-house movements and everything. There's issues with those movements, all of them when they come out. Like quite frankly, there's been issues even with this Omega movement, the newer movement, and then there's issues. I mean, not like catastrophic issues, but there's quirks, I guess, if you will. So when you're dealing with, say, the ETA 2824, or even a Seiko NH35, which I'm not a huge fan of thinking of that movement as like any sort of refined movement. It's more of a workhorse type thing, but there's quirks with new movements. So, the 2824, the 2892, those things are kind of good to go. So, and it's nice, I guess, that in the watch world there's new developments in movements, but sometimes maybe just don't fix it if it isn't broken. Maybe just get the movements that are already available, but in a higher grade, or do your own regulation. Cowboy Swami, yeah, the 2892 is a much thinner, well, as far as movements go. I mean, in real life, it's not that much thinner, like a millimeter or something, but it's much thinner than the 2824. I think there's some other different pitches and stuff like that with it. It's not like a thinned out 2824. It's its own movement, but. Snuffbeard says, "Hey Rob, love the channel. I'm looking into buying the black titanium G-Shock Square, but the camo is growing on me. What's your pick?" Well, I sold my camo one and I kept the black one. So I personally, if you're gonna only own, now it depends on if you like a little bit of flash. If you're only going to own one titanium square, I would pick this one. I like the gold colored accents. I like the positive display. It's like one of the only positive display. Well, I guess I got some plastic G-Shocks that are positive display. But, in this one, we're calling it like the stealth wealth or whatever, because it's the retail on it's like 1700 or whatever. But you can pick them up for like $1,000. Bergman, have I ever held a Gorilla watch? I don't think so. What is the model number of the Oris? I got the box is all closed and stuff. I don't know. I really don't know what the model number technically is on this. Bobby Legg says he has, Bobby has both the original camo and the black titanium. And yeah, I will do a review. Every watch you see that I get in, I will do a video on. But I still have the blue camo, and then I have the black one. And honestly, the blue one I really didn't care for anymore, but then the blue one's actually grown on me quite a bit. So I'm more likely to have this one coexist with this one versus the regular camo one with this one for some reason. This combo just makes more sense to me. I know that none of them actually make sense, but yeah, Dane, don't spend like you can pick these up for like $1,000, I think, ish, 1,200 maybe. And then somebody did mention that this Orient Star is very difficult to get. This watch was sent in to me by, hopefully I didn't screw this up. I think Stuart sent this in. And it was supposed to go on the chopping block and everything like that, but I pretty much get first dibs on these watches when they come in, right? So I haven't paid them yet, but I'm gonna pick this one up off them because I've always lusted after, and I know this one doesn't have the lyre lugs, but I've always loved the Omega Aquaterra. And this one just, oh man, this one just screams Aquaterra. So, and it has the crazy good anti-reflective coating top and bottom, which I really love. On these watches with really nice polished, almost black polished indices and hands, and then that kind of like teak looking deck. What, first dibs? Yeah. I mean, I gotta have some benefits for seeing all these watches. I mean, look at this on my wrist. Plus, I love white dials. Like, I would regret not picking this up. Let's just say that. It feels perfect on wrist. And they do pop up occasionally, but they're hard to find now. Let's see. Pretty much everyone's, let's see. Colin says pretty much everyone's order of the GW5000 from Casio. Ah, black. Yeah, I've heard a couple of people said they bought it and then basically got the email saying that they weren't going to send it. That's a bummer. Bergman says, do you think Oris will make a smaller 42 skeleton PPX with 5 day power reserve? Boy, I don't know. That's a pretty expensive venture for them, and I don't know how well that was received. I don't know that they really like sold out of those really quick. I would say probably not right away. Maybe later in 2021, but maybe. Oh, Stuart's in the chat. Thanks. The Laurier is on the way. Yeah, we'll talk soon, buddy. Let's see. Let's see. Rob, after checking so many reviews of the square, got the full steel square so far. Rest of my watches are spending much time in the drawer. Yeah, the steel squares, I mean, there's so many greats. I mean, even just the all black one, which I think some people are just sleeping on, you know, they get it and then they're so focused on the other ones and everything, but this one's like really cool. Just the all black one. So clean looking. Get a reflection off the crystal on that. Let's see. Hey Rob, any idea if Damasco has discontinued DA model, the rotating bezel three-hand version? I have no idea. Yes, indeed, Nefarian, the Aquas. I am really loving this watch. I'm not 100% sure, because I typically don't go after blue dial watches. And I do prefer the darker blue. And in most lights, because I don't stand out in the sun a ton, right? So most of the blue is going to look a little bit more subdued or navy. And I like that blue. I don't know. I might try to pick this one up. I don't know if Oris will sell me this actual one, but I might try. It is a blue bezel. I know it's hard to see, and I'll try to get some outside shots of this, but it's a really dark, I don't know what you call it, navy, and it is the bezel on this is perfect, absolutely perfect. Honestly, I know they had to do something a little more grabby with the dial, but if they would have done even a flat dial in here, the same color as the bezel, I would have been even probably more drawn to it. I know a lot of people like the you know, shimmery type dials, but which probably goes better with the polish and everything, but really. I think if they did a matte blue dial and then a full brush to forget about the polish and just go full brush everywhere, that would be pretty hot. I would be all about that. So, Kevin, I definitely want to talk more about that. Kevin says, hard to go with the new Oris when older ones can be had for about $1,000. So, older ones, yeah. But if you want the newer style handset and everything like that, you're probably going to get them for, I don't know, 14, 1500 bucks, maybe up to two. So when you look at the newer one versus the new one with the new movement, then the price difference is like slimmer. So, but that kind of can be said with a lot of watches. You can get the older versions typically a lot cheaper, so it's hard to justify the newer ones. You know, as they move forward though, it's nice when they put out new generations because it's either going to do one of two things, right? It's either going to devalue some of the old original ones, or it could potentially make them even more valuable, depending on the brand and what it had and how desirable they are and everything like that. I'm sure there's some earlier models that are actually a little bit higher in price depending on the colorway. So, MJ says that one's, this blue one's not on their website. I don't know. I thought it was when I looked. Maybe their picture just isn't good. Yeah, the movement's really cool. I like the new movement on it. Mike, 100%. Yeah, the previous generation Seamasters. So not the generation right before this, even though that one actually did increase too. I remember I sold mine for a song. But the generation even before that, where it had like the sword hands and stuff, those are going way up in price. Let's see. Young says, any thoughts on when they will have an upgrade in-house movement for the Big Crown Pointer Dateline? Probably next year. I've heard rumor that they're going to try to stuff one of these in a pointer date. We'll see if it actually comes to fruition, but that is the rumor on the street. Yeah, I like brands when they just give it like a name, but even Omega really like has like crazy long reference numbers and stuff like and I mean even Seiko has like shorter reference numbers, but and then the fans name them. So let's see. If they up the price and make upgrades to the newer model, like the King Turtle or new Marine Master, then maybe it's worth it. Yeah. Orient reference numbers are crazy. Oh, man. Yeah, the Orient ones are just absurd. And I don't know. I'm sure maybe they make sense to somebody, but I don't like them at all. It makes it hard to go find like older stuff. Like you have to like take notes and dig further, which I guess maybe would increase the joy of the hunt, but not for me, man. Dane is saying some information about the Omega Silver Snoopy Award watch, asking if anybody knows about the availability time frame. Is anybody having trouble with their watch fund and having a hard time getting the funds to buy a watch? Might I recommend just picking up a World Timer? Good, cheap, clean, wholesome fun right here. Always on board for a World Timer, guys. And you can mod them, have fun with them. If you're getting burned out or whatever, just go to Amazon and just order up a World Timer. You can't go wrong. Just saying. What do they do with the other one? Another one somewhere. Maybe I already boxed it up. Let's see. Where's that swatch at? I want it. Which one? I got a couple swatches in right now. Or Vostok. Yeah, the Vostoks are actually kind of cool, but you got to like stagger those out. Like maybe plan on like the first week or the last week of every month. Just go and pick up, like, buy an order of Vostok, and then you'll forget about it. And by the time you're ordering, like, your second or third one, your first one will show up. You could get in a weird Vostok rotation. That'd be kind of fun to do. Oh, Rio with a good question. Do you think you will review a Bulova Actron Space View 2020? Probably not. Mike is asking, where's the best place to buy your Vostoks? eBay. You can do eBay. What is that? There's an authorized AD. Was it Merriman or something like that? I think that's what it's called. There's some Vostok fans in the chat, I'm sure. Isn't it called Merriman or something? I forget the name of the website. I can't say it. I don't even know. Maybe put a link up. You should be able to find it though. The Russian site has better prices of their stock. Yes, Merriman or something like that. Yep. And they usually have a ton. So. And I'll probably do a video soon, with a bunch of Amazon affiliate links with tools and these cheaper watches and stuff like that too. So. Oh. Chaz is saying you can pick up some Vostoks right on Amazon. Interesting. So you can pick it right up on Amazon. Hey, you guys want to see something fun? Let's I want to share with you something fun. Let's check something out real quick. So this is my Discord just for kicks. Hopefully this isn't ruining anything. So this is my Discord chat for my Patreons, which is a pretty small group. This is the founder, like Craig Best, just post up a wrist shot and he's actually watching the live stream. So maybe he can snap a picture of me videoing his picture of him watching the live stream. And then there's a bunch of different chats over here. These are all the tours going. You can see there's a Borealis. There's two Borealises going. The Nove, a couple of Spinnakers. Actually, I think one of those needs to be returned. I can't remember. The Zealous is on the way back. There's an Axios out there. The Stella. There's two Zealous Makos going. Let's see. The Vario's gone. The Crown Heart. The Dorenzo's going. Timex. These three I need to ship still. Those are all tour watches. Then we got the founder chat. Yeah, Mike is just saying right there, watching us, watching you. So, yeah, there's a wrist shot. And usually the wrist shots actually go up in this thread here is the wrist shots. So you'll see these are just random wrist shots guys will post up in the Discord chat. So, and I'll talk more about some of this stuff soon because I'm going to change the way things are done. But we do a lot of cool stuff in here. There's a lot of talk. We got a new one in the founders chat. Yeah. A lot of us talk on here, guys. A lot of good fun on here. Figured I'd just share that a little bit with you. About the abrupt movements, but I wanted to share that with you guys. It's kind of cool. I'm very active on that too. So, Rio says is asking, do I still have the Bilova surfboard? Do you still have fun with that? I never actually really wore it. I loaned it out to Dane, and then Dane sent it over to Chris from the Watch Lounge. Or is it vice versa? I can't remember. Yeah, I think I sent it to Dane, and then Dane sent it to Chris, and then I think I don't know if Chris sent it out yet, but I think Chris was going to send it over to Kevin over at Wrong Time Watch. So it's kind of making a little mini tour of some other channels because in my Discord, there's like 17 different YouTube channels on there. So yeah, it's going to get lost. It's going to end up getting lost, and I will have never worn it a full day. I do want to see the watch back at some point, though, because I will actually wear it. I like the size. I like the color of it, the pop of orange, and then the surfboard on it. You know, people call it like a surfboard look. I actually think it looks more like a instrument cluster on a car, like with a speedometer and tach as the subdials. But Kevin is asking my thoughts on the new Baltic GMT and the Laurier GMT. I sent a message over to Laurier about the GMT, and I haven't heard back from him. And I have not looked at the Baltic GMT. Yeah. Oh, okay, Chris did send it out to Kevin. Thanks, man. I appreciate it. I can't keep track of that stuff too good. So there's a lot of watches coming and going all the time. So yeah, that one's over at Kevin. Kevin will do a video on it, and then I'll see if somebody else wants it. Maybe. Pete over at Chilling with Watches or Casper over at Ghost Watches or one of the other channels, J City or there's so many great channels. I'll probably let that one just kind of run through some other channels. I think it's one of those watches that a lot of people are interested in, but they're not like, I mean they're pretty affordable. They're just not super super cheap. I think I paid. I think I can share this. I think I paid $327.50 for it, is what I paid for it. So, for that Bilova surfboard thing. Dane's directing people towards eBay. I don't know what we're looking for. Well, that beer's empty. Scott is asking, what else do I have on the table? You mean like off site where you can't see? I have that. Always looking for a Tron. Here's a Tron. It's not for sale. I think somebody in our group had a Tron for sale. I don't know if they all sold them or... Nefarian, yes, I do have a Joma Shop discount code. I have a lot of discount codes, and I share them with my in my Patreon group, which is no longer going to be a Patreon group, but we'll talk more about that soon. Yeah. Ooh, Chaz says he has that titanium citizen bullhead you were wanting to see. Yes, I do want to see that. If you would like to send that in, email me, Chaz, because I would definitely like to see that. Bobby's going to go with the rebuy on the Tron. Don't do it. It looks Photoshopped. It always looks, as long as you don't get any glare on it or something, it just looks Photoshopped all the time. Mark is saying, are we going to be the group formerly known as Patreon? No, you're just going to be founders. There's going to be founders and co-founders. Oh, this is on the table, the... Notice sector. This was sent in. And I think some people are divisive on the date placement. I think it's great because I like having a date on there, even though this one's tiny and it's hard to read sometimes. But this is such a great watch. I don't know where it's at. Oh, yeah, I can go get it. Hold on a second. Who wanted to see that? Jordan wants to see the blue swatch irony. Hold on a second. Cowboy Swami says, what's my thoughts on the full tag amended Zen, worth the extra money? For some people, yes. For me, no, because I wear my watches so light, I'm fine with just regular stainless steel. All right, let me grab that swatch. It's behind me. I have to do a few more things to my room, and then I'll probably share my the room with you guys. I did a few other changes, so. Rio's asking, hey, Random Rob, any rumors of a new Seiko Monster or Samurai that you'll want to purchase? The Samurais, no. I don't anticipate picking up any Samurais. The newer Monsters, I'm excited to see what they do. I'm still hoping for a full stainless bezel instead of, it seems like all they do are the coated bezels. So like, you know, this one's obviously coated. I'm still really hoping for some nice colors, orange maybe, and a regular clear stainless steel bezel on that. So let's see. Michael Parr says, my Captain Willard came in earlier, just unbox and unwrap the plastic. While not large, hefty watch in weight. The Willards are awesome. I really want the green one. Yes, and Kevin, that MM200 with the steel bezel does look great. I'm hoping to get one of those on the channel to video as well. John, anybody have Discord? A lot of people have Discord. I have a private Discord that it's not full access to everybody. It's like just a private group, which is going to go through some changes here soon in January, but I'm not sure. I gotta wait for the dust to settle before I actually share if there's any slots available, because right now it's going to be maxed out. There's going to be 100 founders and 100 co-founders, but right now I think they have about 150 or something like that people in my Patreon group, but that's all going to change here soon. Kevin, the new blue Hamilton looks very nice. Yes, absolutely. And as soon as Mimo gets those, he's got those on order. As soon as he gets those in, I will have those in to share with you guys. I'm excited to see those new Hamilton. Hamilton has a bunch of really cool watches coming out right now. They're just spectacular looking. Mark said Mimo should have about 2 weeks. Yeah, everything's a little delayed, but the Seiko Willard in pictures and videos has an aggressive chamfer crystal. Does it still have an inner chapter ring? Or is this? I think it has the metal ring. If I'm not mistaken, I think it has the metal ring, like the 63 MAS that you're talking about, and then the index, or the, you know, the marks, the minute marks or second marks or whatever, are on the dial. Floridian is saying, will you spin the wheel. What wheel? For the yeah, for a lot of the giveaways and the sales and everything like that, I do the spin the wheel thing. Michael says, I don't do pin and collars, so I'll have the guy in the mall do it for 15 bucks a brace. Unless you really trust the guy in the mall, I don't know. I think unless there's something preventing you from actually learning on how to do the pin and collar, I think you would be way better off learning how to do it yourself. So there's a couple different devices you can get. You can get this thing, and it's weird because you have to kind of set it up, but these are great for doing pin and collar. And these are all pretty affordable. This one's even cheaper, I think. You can do the pin and collar with this one, and it's captured and it's slow and controlled. You're not going to have any issues with it. I think there's even a couple handheld ones. I really like this one. It's a little weird because you think it's going to be like it's going to make things easier for you, and it doesn't necessarily make it easier, but it makes it controlled. So everything's deliberate, and you won't have any issues when you're doing deliberate movements versus just using a block and like a pin or something. So this way you can absolutely do it. I know there's people that use even more primitive tools than this, but if you're gonna be in the watch game, then I think invest in a couple of overall pretty affordable tools, and I think they'll do well for you. The Seiko, yeah, you can get these. I think I picked this up on Esslinger. I think I already did a video of this. I think I did a video of this and I provided a link. It's just the Seiko S926. I don't think there's very good instructions on how to use it, but you have a screwdriver that you can use in a controlled fashion so you don't even slip and scratch like the side of your links. A lot of people will do that. The pin, so for driving out pin and collar or even split pins, the size of this here is the right size so you don't end up, because the old way that I would do pin and collar is I would just use a Bergeon or whatever, and I would just use their thing. But anybody that's used this, then you'll know that when you do the pin and collar, especially like on a monster or something with the collars on the outside, it gets stuck around here and then you have to like get it off the pin. So this is like just the right size to get jammed up. Whereas the one on the actual Seiko tool is a smaller size and it works good. So don't be afraid of pin and collar, guys. Just get maybe invest in the right tool. And I personally love this one, but like I said, you can use these. These work as well. That's a nice size. That one's even smaller than the Seiko one. And you just push it down. And usually just pushing it down will drive it out. And it's all captured. And then, you can do screws. This one's cool too because say you have like there's a few bracelets out there that actually have a screw on each side. I think Omega does it. I don't know if Tag does it. There's a couple other brands that do it. You can rig this one up so that you have a fixed flat blade on the bottom, and then you have your blade up here. So I don't know that you can do that with the Seiko one. You can do it with this one though. And there's some other tools that I picked up too. I just haven't had the time to do a bunch of tool videos. Yeah, I still. Like unless it's someone that you trust to size your bracelet, I personally, the way I think, if anybody's gonna mess up my watch, it's gonna be me. I'm not gonna pay someone else to screw up my watch. Craig Best says, Rob, show us the white dial Astor Banks. I don't have a white dial Astor Banks. I have this white dial MMI. Is that the one you're talking about? I don't think I have an Astor Banks in right now. I need to get that one in. They're supposed to send me one, so But this is the MMI turret, and this one has the internal date disc on it. I just did the recording, the video for these guys earlier today, and I'll post it. I need to probably post it up tomorrow because the Kickstarter for these actually starts on the 27th, and I'm going to send these out to Kevin over at Wrong Time Watch. I'm going to mail these out tomorrow so he can get a video on them too. Yeah, these MMIs are awesome, and these are the prototypes, and they're actually like 90% there. Like, there's a couple changes that Victor's doing to them, and then they're going to be like spot on. So CMO says he hopes they update the loom to C3 or BGW9. It sounds like he's going to, because I've been talking to him a little bit. Twin Tank Design says you have to get the mint green Aster Banks Fortitude. I'll hit him up. I think they were supposed to send me one, and there's a lot of companies out there right now that said they're going to send me some watches, and I just haven't had them arrive yet. Carlos is asking, any microscope tool to fix watches suggestion? So that's a good question. Where was it? Carlos asked a good question. Here's what I use. These are, I think I picked them up on Amazon. And these are just a plus three reader glasses, which is more than, does that bug you guys out? It's more than what I don't wear readers anyway to read, but for looking up close, I was using, like the headgear thing that you can buy to work on watches, and I just struggled with them. They didn't really work for me, and I think it's partly because they're set up for right eye dominant, and I'm actually left eye dominant, and I know I could switch it all around, and maybe I'll invest in a better quality set of headgear, but I just went with these plus three readers. That's all I use. If I could go plus four, I would like to maybe try the plus fours as well, and maybe have a couple different pair. So yeah, it's super convenient. You can prop them down towards the end of your nose so you can still look over them, old man style or whatever, and still get, and they're cheap. They're pretty cheap. I did notice that it was difficult. I don't know if I bought these locally or if on Amazon. I think I picked them up on Amazon. A lot of the drugstores, I don't know if they go as high as plus three. I think plus two and a half maybe is the norm. I don't know. We'll see. Nick is asking, what time do these live streams start? I usually start about 8 o'clock, run them for about an hour or so. Is anyone else's screen blurry in the background? Jeffrey, will this help? Will that help? Is that better? Sorry. You're not getting notifications. Screen clear here. Cool, that's a good option. Floridian is asking, are they going to hold any watch trade shows in 2021? What is the status virtual? I think there was a lot of effort put toward from the places that do the watch shows. I think there was a lot of effort pushed toward the virtual world, and they did them, right? And they did them, I think, pretty successfully. However, I don't think they're getting the views that they would hope to. We have to get back to actually hands-on and actually meeting people, even if it means that, we're gonna get past this, the not gathering and stuff like that. We're gonna get past that, and we're gonna get back to actually gathering and meeting each other and actually talking face to face. That's going to happen. Is it gonna happen in 2021? I really hope so. I really hope so. Even if it's like, mid-year or towards the fall, if that's the soonest, then that's fine. Earlier the better, as far as I'm concerned. Let's just get this going and let's do it. So that should happen, I think, next year. I think it'll happen. I think it'll happen based on me not knowing much. So don't take my word for it. Jim C is asking, do I use Loctite when sizing? If it's a watch that I know I'm actually going to keep and probably wear, then yeah, I'll throw a little purple Loctite on it, or maybe even a little bit higher. But a lot of screw links in brands. Well, if you when you pull the screw out, the hardware, you'll see there's actually a little bit of stuff on them already, And if there is, then that's fine. Just I would just put that back in. Mark is saying a blog to watch did one, and Worn and Wound virtual one. So did Microlux. They did one. They did a really good one too. So let's see. Twin Tank says, what's your most exciting recent watch release? Boy, I don't know. Release. I would have to say probably this Oris is probably the most exciting. I mean, there's a bunch of really cool new stuff out, but this is the most exciting in the fact that it's a full launch of a new movement and everything. It's exciting to see a brand like Oris that is independently owned and as far as anyone can tell is going to continue to stay that way, that will, you know, can continue to innovate and push forward with what they have. If you're seeing a little bit of lag or blurry or something like that, I got both my kids at home because of, you know, Thanksgiving break and stuff like that. They're probably streaming and stuff. They're probably hogging all the internet. So my bandwidth might be like kind of messed up. Mark is asking, will Oris let you check out their 10-day? Listen, I don't know what Oris is going to do. I'm blown away that Oris reached out to me for this model. I think I'm still on a high from that, and I've been wearing that thing nonstop. So I did ask them about future ones, just kind of like passive aggressively seeing if this is a relationship that's going to develop, and I hope that's the case. So, but if not, I can still get in Oris from I can get Oris in from Saltzman's. So let's see. Yeah, you can jump down to 720 because these aren't going to be posted in high def when they're live. It's too much bandwidth for for the YouTube and everything. Brock is asking, have I ever seen or reviewed Aragon watches? I don't know. I'd have to look through my archives. It sounds familiar, but I don't know that I have. Maybe one day. I kind of pretty much rely on people sending in watches, so. Let's see. Interested in your opinion with Seiko LX line matching Grand Seiko watches in price. I don't play around with Grand Seiko, and I'm certainly not going to play around with LX. For me, Seiko needs to be, you know, old school, like, you know, SKX, Monster, you know, on the high end, the Willards, you know, those are like $1,000. That's my happy place with Seiko. I'm not spending, I'm in that same camp I think a lot of people have talked about in the past, where if I'm going to spend that kind of money, then I'm looking at like Swiss and higher end stuff. I can't see spending that much on Seiko. I can't. Walt, yeah, Zodiac is an awesome brand. There's so many really good brands out there that I think people are sleeping on. So, Scott asked about my case back removal tool. You know, I do have a couple mod builds coming up. And let's see, what do I have? These things work excellent for Seiko. I label this one for Turtle, but a lot of the mod cases for SKXs actually have this spacing for the Turtle. And I've had people ask me about these. You used to be able to pick these up on eBay. I don't know what happened. The seller's gone. They're not making them anymore. I don't know what the case is. But these are, you know, brass pins, so you don't typically aren't going to scratch up your case. You can see I've nicked them up pretty good. And I don't know if anybody else is going to make any of these or what. But these are pretty cool. But really, again, a more controlled manner. If you're going to do a lot of case back removal, there is some, I mean, you can get super expensive ones where they're fixed and you lock it down in a vise. I think securing the watch is important. And I kind of have a vise where I can do that. And then you can use, you know, the two-prong tool and get a nice bite on it and protect everything else and just do a slow controlled movement. You can do it by hand, but that's risky. I think putting it in a machine to do it is better. But yeah, the first time you get them off, I've had some that they don't want to come off. So And those ones are the ones that you're going to scratch something typically. And the rubber ball is not going to give you enough grip to get it off on some of these. In the process of creating a white dial explorer homage, any strap suggestions since you're the expert with white dials? I like bracelets, but with white dial, I think, you know, going with something kind of rich and brown and more like authentic to what you would think leather is, and then maybe some white stitching, I think this would look really good. Oh, G-Man down. I think this kind of strap looks really good with white. Of course, you can go with black, but I think maybe try to do a little pop of white in the strap so it ties in, it balances it out. You know, in this case, like it has the black bezel, you could certainly go darker or with a full black strap if it's a diver, but you're not going to have a diver. So I think a really nice rich brown with white thread. This is actually a really nice strap too. I might try to swipe this. Who made this? It's a Sweden made strap. What do we got here? We got about 4 minutes left. What else we got, guys? Got to run. Everyone have a happy, safe Floridian. Always a pleasure to have you on board. Thanks for joining us. And I might do a live stream. I don't know if there's a demand for it on Thanksgiving. If somebody's bored, you know, usually people are busy with family and everything, but I know this is kind of a weird year because they're, you know, not wanting people to gather. So I might throw up a live stream on Thanksgiving Day for you guys. Just do a quick one, just impromptu, and maybe we can all meet and chat for a little bit. Maybe I can do a guest. Maybe we can do a little FaceTime guest speaker on Thanksgiving Day if I can sucker somebody else to go in on it with me. But I'm off all this week, so I'm going to try to put in some more work in this watch game here. So James Duffy's going to be cooking and trying on watches. Yeah, me too. You know, I'm going to hang out with a little bit of family. It's going to be a super, super small gathering. So and Dane obviously is going to go full on sports. So Mike says Thanksgiving was in October. Can we all do a Zoom call? Nick, you know what? So in my Discord, I do like we did it once actually. We do like it's kind of like a Zoom, but it's just audio. There's no video. We do like a little meeting or something. I'm going to probably make that a regular thing as well. If you're in, yeah, 4-day weekend, man. You got Thursday, Friday, and Saturday and Sunday off. That's awesome. That's my normal. So I was automatically going to have Thursday, Friday off, Saturday, Sunday, but I took Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday to really enjoy the week. So let's see. Any affordable salmon dial watches really looking for one? I can't think of any off the top of my head, but I know there is. There's a couple of micros out there. Actually, Zelos, now that I think about it, I think Zelos put out one, and that was like the first one to sell out, so those are gone. But how do you get in Discord? I'm a Patreon. How do you not? Cowboy Swami, I don't know. Can you email me or something? We'll have to talk. Maybe send me an email. Or send me a message in the Patreon thing and send me a message. We'll get you taken care of. Mark is saying Aviate has a salmon dial one. Just bought a quartz one for $200. That's pretty good. Oh, yeah. Man, there's going to be all kinds of killer sales and everything, too. Oh, man, Nick, you have the frozen shoulder. That sucks, man. You got to do some serious PT to get that worked on, too. That's a bummer. Rio's asking about the Aorus movement and what the materials are inside. You know what? I don't know a ton of that. I think it does because it's, you know, anti-magnetic and all that stuff. I'll try to go a little in depth on that, but I know like Bruce already has a video. There's already some good videos out there on that. So Dana's saying, I'm going to say Zelos because that's how Dane says it. Zelos is coming out with a new diver design, the black tip. Watch for it. Keep an eye out for Zelos, man. I'm telling you, Zelos is crushing it. I'm in the Facebook group, hadn't seen anything. Well, man, you guys got to know, like, you got to listen to Dane. Like, watch his videos and listen to him if he ever talks about Zelos, because he's kind of got the inside track on a lot of that stuff. Yeah, the bezel on the Oris is very nice. The bezel on the Oris is really nice, but it is, I have to say, I really like the feel and the sound of it. It's a different sound than you would typically have, but there is this like where it like preloads and then bounces back. So I don't want to say I'm disappointed. It's just the way this one operates, and I'm used to like the Omega, and then even the Christopher Ward bezel action is phenomenal. But I really like the sound of this one. It doesn't sound like any other dive watch out there. I think it's just a great sounding bezel. See, have I checked out the new rubber Tropic strap on the old company that made them come back to business? No, I haven't. I know, what's his name? Uncle Seiko's got a couple new colorways. He's got like a dark green one too. So, real ball bearings in the air. I don't know. Maybe it is. Maybe that's why it sounds like that. Maybe that is ball bearing. I don't know. Can you guys hear that? That is a killer sounding bezel. I absolutely love the sound and the feel of that bezel. It is so good. Let's see. All right. Well, I'm past an hour anyway, guys. I'm gonna kill it. Everyone, thanks for chiming in. That went fast. I think in the future, as my channel grows and I get maybe more people in the live, like we're at 120-ish people in, maybe I'll go longer. Maybe I'll go hour and a half, 2 hours, or something like that. So, but that's in the future. There's gonna be a lot of changes coming in 2021. It's gonna be all good. There's gonna be a lot of fun. So, and Dane's bummed out. He only got to get one troll. But listen, I'm gonna shoot for going live on Thanksgiving, and I'll try to maybe put up a post in the community tab in my on my channel, and maybe I'll select a time so maybe we can all meet. But it'll probably maybe do like before everybody eats. That way, I can just chill the rest of the night or something like that. But yeah, I'll try to shoot for like maybe lunchtime-ish or something on Thanksgiving. Maybe we'll try to shoot for noon-ish if that works for everybody. We'll see. We'll see what works. But thanks for watching, guys. Tomorrow morning I'll drop an unboxing, and then tomorrow I'll drop a regular video. So stay tuned. Thanks for watching, guys. I'll see you on the next vid.